entering into the praise zone when you get your praise on. Hi, I'm your sister in Christ, Michelle Rice, and I will be your praise pilot for this heavenly flight. We will be going up, up, up in the high praises of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. While you're in the praise zone, getting your praise on, the Father will enthrone the praises of His own. So come on, come on, come on now. Get your praise on in the praise zone. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord God. Father God, we glorify you. Father God, we come to you in the name of Jesus. We come to you reminiscing, Lord God, of your glory. We come reminiscing to you about your power. We come reminiscing to you about your goodness, Lord. We come reminiscing of all your mighty ways and all your mighty acts, God. And we come reminiscing about what the songwriter sung one time. He says, I need thee, oh Lord, I need thee. Every day and every hour, I need thee. Father God, hallelujah. You're the air we breathe, Lord God. And the name of Jesus. You're the food we eat, God, in the name of Jesus. You're the water we drink, God, in the name of Jesus. And we'll be careful, God, to know that we need you at all times. We need you in the morning, need you in the noonday, and we need you when the sun goes down. Here on the praise zone, we get your praise on in Jesus' name. Now, the song today that we're going to hear is a good, encouraging, uplifting song entitled No Way, the GHN. But touch your back. Get your praise zone in the praise zone.
Let's go!
Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's no way, no way, no way we can make it without you, Lord Jesus. In 2 Corinthians 3 and 5 sums it all up. It says, not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves, but our sufficiency is of God. Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves, but our sufficiency, come on somebody, is in God. Now that word sufficient here in the text is a Greek word pronounced hikonos, whose Greek root word is pronounced hikonu, which means to enable, to qualify, to make able. And that word is also taken from another Greek word, which means ability and sufficiency. So we have the word sufficient meaning to enable, to qualify, to make able, and ability and sufficiency. Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves, but our sufficiency is of God. Hallelujah. That's why you got to keep coming boldly. You got to keep coming boldly to the throne of grace to find mercy and grace to help. To find help in a time of need. See, when you go to God, you always go to God needing help. You always got to go to God saying, Lord, I need your help. I need you, oh God. You need his help. Hallelujah. You always go to God with a spirit of poorness. Say, Lord, I'm poor and needy without you. I need you, Lord. I need you every day. I need you every move I make. I need you. Always go to God in an empty state, not in a full state. Now, when you come to God with fullness of yourself, or you think you got it going on, you don't need nothing, the Bible says in Revelation 3:17, God says you wretched, miserable, poor, blind, and naked. Hallelujah, because you need him. Thank you, Jesus. God, you better keep looking unto the hills, for whence cometh your help. Your help comes from the Lord, who made the heavens and the earth. Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything above ourselves. Our sufficiency is of God. Hallelujah. Even Jesus says in St. John 15, without me, you can do nothing. Hallelujah. Apart from me, Jesus says you can do nothing. But thanks be unto God, according to Philippians 4:13, that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. We can do all things through Christ who empowers us. We can all do all things through Christ who enables us. Hallelujah. Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves. Our sufficiency is of God. And it's not by might, nor by power, but by his spirit. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. It's not by might, nor by power that we can preach. It's not by might, nor by power that we can teach. It's not by might, nor by power that we prophesy. It's not by might, nor by power that you lay hands on the sick and they recover. It's not by might, nor by power. Hallelujah. That you cast out devils. It's all about Jesus. And it's all in Jesus' name. It's the Holy Ghost that is our helper. It's the Holy Ghost that is our teacher. It's the Holy Ghost that is our paraclete. It's the Holy Ghost that is our intercessor. It is God himself that enables us. Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves. Our sufficiency is of God. For it's in him we live and him we move and in him we have our being. And we might as well not even move at all unless we're moving in him. Hallelujah. We're not sufficient in of ourselves because he is our confidence. It is he is our confidence. We don't have self-confidence. We're not confident in our education, ain't confident in our abilities, ain't not confident in our gifts, not confident in our talents, but we're confident in him. We have confidence in him. Hallelujah. This is the confidence that we have in him, that we ask anything according to his word. He hears us. And if he hears us, we know we have the petitions that we desire of him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So you got to keep on trusting because you have confidence in him. You trust in him. This is the confidence that we have in him. Hallelujah. To trust in the Lord and lean not to our own understanding. In all our ways acknowledge him and he will direct our path. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now this message was so important to me. This message was so powerful to me because God told me, he said, is your Messiah first that ministers the message to the messenger. Let me say that again. It's the Messiah who ministers the message to the minister first. Hallelujah. He's talking to me. He said, now Michelle, tell me, have you become sufficient in yourself? Do you think it's you now? Hallelujah. Because it's all about him. When people say, Michelle, it's a wonderful thing how you remember those scriptures. You can quote the scripture. You got it right on target. But God said, is it you now? Hallelujah. Are you sufficient in and of yourself? Hallelujah. The Bible said it's the Holy Ghost that brings back to our remembrance whatsoever he have told us. We're not sufficient in myself. God, I'm not sufficient in myself. Hallelujah. Some people compliment me. Say, Michelle, it seems like you have a smile on your face, a joy in your heart. You encourage people all the time. But God said, hallelujah, you're not sufficient enough of yourself. Because God said, I remember the day when you were so discouraged, so despondent, so depressed and debilitated that you couldn't even get out of bed. So it's not you now, is it? That joy is not you, is it, Michelle? Hallelujah. I've learned to understand that the sufficiency is not in myself. Hallelujah. And the confidence that we walk in, the confidence we have in God, when we walk up, we have courage and boldness. We can lift our head up in courage, not in vanity, but in courage. That confidence did not come from us. God, the confidence did not come from me, oh God. Because I remember the day, Lord, that I was so, had so low self-esteem. I walked down with my head to the ground. Couldn't even look a person in the eye. Hallelujah. I realized, God, that confidence comes from you, Lord. And I'm not sufficient in myself to think anything of myself, but my sufficiency is of God. So I must humble myself continuously. We all must humble ourselves underneath the mighty hand of God, that he will exalt us in due time. Get your praise on in the praise zone. Now let me say a quick prayer for you. Hallelujah. Before we end the show. Now, Lord God, I pray for my sisters and brothers out there. I'm praying right now, God, that you will encourage them, Lord God, and continue to speak to their heart, Lord God. Minister to them, Lord God, about the need to humble themselves and to realize that whatever we have, whatever gift we have, whatever talent we have, Lord, whatever thing we do, Lord God, in life, no matter how far we go, God, no matter how far you take us, God, no how far you lift us up, God, no matter what, God, no matter what kind of wealth you give us, not the homes, the cars, the lands, it don't mean nothing, Lord God, without you. We need you in the morning, God. We need you at all times. And it's not our sufficiency, oh God, but it's your sufficiency. And we give you praise. On the praise zone, we get your praise zone. See you next time. Bye-bye.